Hello, everybody, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Right in front of me is Grayson, the Goron dude man, who is going to... Who are you? I'm Grayson. I like repeating myself, so just remember it for next time. This guy's, like, very construction worker. He's like, hey, what do you want? I gotta talk him into going to a town that a friend of mine is trying to build. He needs some rocks punched, and this is my man. I'm a digger here, as you can see. Dig a tunnel, dig a tunnel. Dig a tunnel, gonna dig a tunnel. Stop. Quick before the hyenas come. I feel like maybe I'm not meant to toil away in obscurity like this. Is there a job out there for me that would let me use my strength to make a difference? Yes. Where? Please tell me more. Tarrytown. Tarrytown? I've never heard of it. What's the deal with that place? Well, it's brand new and they need you to punch rocks. It's in Akala. Tarrytown. Alright, so there's somewhere out there that needs me. Akala's not too far from here. Alright, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna strike while the iron is hot. I like that that's not a Goron phrase, but it feels like it should be. Thanks for letting me know, brother. Pelison and I are gonna head there right now. God, is this fucking guy's name Pelison? While I'm at it. Pelison, we're gonna leave. Oh shit, he's got a little kid. Eh? I should have asked him to be my construction worker. Fuck! I've made a huge mistake. I should have asked the little kid to do it. Then I get back there and Stevenson, or whatever his fucking name is, he's watching this little kid punch these rocks, and he's going, I don't know, man, that Link kid, he's rolling in money, but he's got no idea how construction works. This is a kid that's got more dollars than cents, if you know what I'm saying. You probably wouldn't know what I was saying, because there aren't any dollars in Hyrule. But if there were... If there even were. This has been a fun set of side quests so far. Hit Grayson. I don't mean to out the identity of Nightwing. Pardon me, if you've never seen Batman or Teen Titans or any of those other shows. I forget how I watched it. I watched it online somewhere. There was a really cool Teen Titans movie called... The Judas Contract? There's a string of DC animated superhero films. Golden Falcon. Falcon Bow, that's what I wanted. There's a string of DC animated superhero movies where... Oh no, I wanted to wear that. Okay. They're a little bit more... Graphic novel? About the Titans? There's movies like Justice League War and The Flashpoint Paradox and The Judas Contract that are a little bit more mature both in subject matter and in presentation than what I remember as being Batman the Animated Series and the Justice League cartoon and, you know, all those shows. Really, really cool way to do things, man. Like, I don't know, just everything about it I think is really, it's really neat. I don't have very much commentary on it because I only saw it once, but, I don't know, like, it's got Deathstroke in it, and he's a fucking maniac. It's got Brother Blood in it, and at one point he's just chilling in a hot tub with like, babes. And it turns out that he's in the hot tub is just the blood of his enemies, and he's like, yeah, this is just how I stay young. He's swimming around in people blood. Like, damn, this is a fucking dark-ass cartoon all of a sudden. Send some Gorons back here, that's perfect. The brute strength of a Goron is undeniable. These boulders don't stand a chance against them, and with names like Grayson and Pelison, they'll fit right in. Also, Pelison started selling the ore found in the boulders. You should go say hello again. Well, next is... 4 more people can move here. We need homes for them to live in. Can you bring me 20 woods? Damn it! All of the fucking wood these guys need! What they need is a goddamn carpenter. Where are the woodcutters in this world? Why do I have to be Link the Commando Jack? I am not even named Grayson or Stevenson or Barfson. I need to have... I'm subcontracting for a contracting company and I'm breaking the fucking rules. If you bring me that, I can combine it with what I already have and get started on new houses. God damn you. All right. Well, I'm definitely not farming up 20 ass pieces of... shit-ass fucking shit-nuts butts. Okay. Man, this little kid, he's ready to sell. What's going on, guy? Big bro Grayson's friend. Need something? I guess. Yeah, I want to know what it costs. What are 10 of these selling for? Son of a bitch. She totally steered me straight, man. That I was convinced. Blink Barfson. Technical term Barf? No, it's what, Commando Jack? Commando, yeah, obviously I'm the Commando Jack. But no, my canonical full name is, Link's name is Link Barfson. Yes, absolutely. For a hot second there, I thought we were talking about me. I have been named Bartholomew Tiberius Jenkins by Cuddles. Somehow, he keeps popping up in this fucking stream. He's not even here. How can we keep getting back on him? String of words I used? I don't remember what I said, man. You can't expect me to remember every single word I say. What does this look like? I'm recording this shit? As you can see, I'm working real hard. Hudson praises me for a ton of breaking these rocks. We'll find some nice ore. My little brother Pellison even started an ore shop. Check it out when you get a chance. Man, I like these guys. This cat's selling rings and things. Why have I not ever found a store in this place called Rings and Things? Why isn't there a jewelry store IRL called Rings and Things? I need you guys to go in with me on a business venture. I don't have any money. My contribution is going to be the name of the store and the idea. We're a jewelry store that is called Rings and Things. The rest of you need to run with it. I need an equal share in the profits. That's how this is going to work. I guess I can turn off that. I'm going to keep advertising for his channel. He better come here, chill out with me sometime. Nah, I'm just kidding. He can do whatever he wants. Because he's a grown adult and he washes his own socks. I'm going to say hello to this guy and he's going to attack me. You guys ready for it? I can't seem to make the dishes I picture in my head. Bah, what happened to inspiration? At times like this, I always say, nothing beats eating a delicious meal. Like bananas? Not only heals your heat and soul, it also can make you heat, cold, shock, or fire resistant, or even stealthier. Dishes are the best. Thanks to cooking, I can move forward in life. I'm glad I became a cook in this crazy world. Why not take a quick look at the ingredients I've gathered? They're all fresh. Son of a bitch, he's not a Yiga. I was convinced that this motherfucker was going to turn into a ninja and try to attack me, and then I was going to kill him and take his money. Yeah, I don't need any of this. No. I'm a traveling chef, and don't you forget it. Alright, cool, Stan. See you later, buddy. I almost ran that guy over, but I didn't mean to, so it makes it better. What's that glowing thing next to the shrine? Is that a fire? This has been a cool zone so far. Oh, and I only mention it because it's popping up on my phone. I feel the need to brag slightly. I came in third place. That's right. Third place. In my, which I think is a lot better than eighth place. In my local friends hanging out, what with the knowing people in the real life, Biggest Loser competition. I lost a couple pounds, and I earned money. I left with the $25 entrance fee that we all, like, I got my entrance fee back. That's all I got. If I had come in second place, I don't even know how much I would have made. But it may come up on my screen here in a second, because that's what my friends are all talking about on our Google Hangout. I always feel the need to brag. Catosa Aug apparatus. Fuck, man, always with these. This is the one thing I cannot stand about this game. The loading screens are annoying, but I deal with it. I hate these motion control dudes. I'm concerned that that's what was throwing me off. Nope, it's fucking backwards. It's fucking backwards even. Have I talked yet on this stream about how stupid golf is, just as an idea? Golf is dumb and stupid. And I'm awesome at it! I'm not very good at golf. Pretty bad. Pretty bad at it. And also, give me back my backwards controls. Nope. Yes. Yes. I was tilting this way, and it was swinging what I would have expected to be this way. Like, none of that made any sense. Also, why isn't there a treasure chest anyplace? Oh, I had to fucking ask, man. Ugh, what's your deal? Oh. Oh, okay, it's not a jump. You're gonna give me a new... Apparently you're not gonna give me a new brick. Oh, you can turn the... Okay. Come on. Come on, get there! Despite the fact that I finished this puzzle, it's still a bad puzzle. I have a hatred for these motion control puzzles, especially when they are fucking backwards. It's alright though, because I am now 25% closer to getting a, another stamina bar. The Great Frost Blade. Okay. My amazingly circuitous plan is one quarter complete. Fuck! I do not understand. I should have revealed that I fell down the cliff. The shame. The shame. Oh, wow. That, none of that was on key, man. And I tried to do that. I'm hunched. Don't judge me. Fuck you. I should have revealed I was deafened by Bender. The shame. The shame. The shame. I don't know where that note is. I'm not a singist. This ain't a music stream. Except for when I'm playing a video game and I'm like, listen to the music. And then I just stop playing. And I'm like, it is fucking great music. It happens sometimes. I've been there. Let's go north a ways. Is it that way? Oh, wait. Good morning. I haven't seen you around here. Yeah, I'm new. Oh, you sure have strange taste. You look like someone who's traveled willy-nilly all over the world. I have. The Peggy Bundy note? I don't get it. Having introduced myself, I'm Nobu. Nobo. Traveled everywhere, but at the end of the day, I like Akala best of all. That's why I'm pretty familiar with stuff around here. Is there something you want to know? You know, Hudson? This area? Farther areas? I know where Hudson is. Let's see, you go west of the stable, there's a sacred place called the Spring of Power. I've been there. Offer a sacred article. Okay, it was part of the princess something or other. Farther areas? There's a lighthouse looking home north of here. No one was there when I stopped by last, though. The voice actress is the same woman who played Peggy Bundy in Married with Children. Really? Hudson, who's that? He's a carpenter? I'm not quite sure. I've been hearing clanging and banging at Lake Akala, that's south of here. Why don't you go check it out? I think I just got a quest to go to the Spring of Power, and I completed it. There it is.
Hey!
By the way, good sir, the outside is crunchy while the inside is chewy. Take one bite and your energy will go through the roof. Go on, try one of our Akala buns. They're a delicacy straight from the East Akala stable. I like it. Thank you so much. One thing to note, Akala buns go bad fast since they're made of fresh ingredients, so you'll have to eat it here. That way we can ensure the quality. Is that okay? Yeah. Thank you so much. That'll be 10 rupees. Yeah, take it. Thanks for your business. Now close your eyes and your open mouth wide. Oh my god. This is bad. I shouldn't be doing any of these things that are just happening. She finds the one-eyed alien named Alcazar that she calls Al. She does her hair like she wanted to sit on the couch and watch TV. I knew that had kind of a sitcom-y feel. I didn't realize that it was a Married with Children reference. Your energy didn't go through the roof. Come back soon. Okay. I think I just performed oral sex on a stable hand, and he was disappointed that my energy didn't go up. Mm-hmm. I think that's what just happened. You're still a kid to me. Size up every vote coming through here. For eligibility, they're different ages, sizes, sometimes even races. It's hard to make a call. I probably look like a creep to them. Al. I love that his backpack has horns on it because he's a beetle. Okay. No, I'd see you again. That technically makes you my stalker. Seriously, I'm gonna have to ask you to stop following me around. Who am I kidding? I love the attention. Fuck, man! I could have come into some big ass money. Alright, it says here that Boxer won $185, Schmidt won $80, and Casey won $25. Fuck! I could have won money! What am I looking for? Carrots, radishes. Radishes are actually pretty useful. I might buy his radishes from him. Resistance to flames. I don't need that shit. Give me the hearts. 64 rupees, just like a Nintendo. Nintendo 64. Test your might. How much was it between me and the second and first place winners? A few percent. I don't remember what the poundage was. We measured it in percentage of weight lost from our original starting weight. No, it wasn't. It wasn't within a pound. It was like 2 or 3% of our original starting weight. Like they. I didn't lose because it was like they put in a lot of hard work. Like they deserve all the recognition for what they did. It's listed in a Google spreadsheet. I don't exactly remember what the numbers were, but I think I was somewhere in the neighborhood of. Yeah, it makes sense. I was somewhere in the neighborhood of 10%. And they were like, they were each like 12 and 13%. What's your deal, robot? You some kind of frog robot? Hey. What are you doing there, dude? I'm just fucking with your robot. Are you the one called Link? Yes. Mm-hmm. That's too bad. If you were the legendary Link, there would be something important I would need to tell you. But how can I determine with full certainty whether or not you are the true hero? How indeed? Hmm? You can show me the wounds your body suffered 100 years ago. That should prove you are truly Link. I got this Master Sword. That's too bad. If you were Link, how can I determine with full certainty? God damn it. I know what I need to do. Damn it. Those seem to have healed. But they do line up with the scars I know you got during the Great Calamity 100 years ago. Yes, I acknowledge you as the real Link. Now take your shorts off and let's figure out what's really going on. I'm the lead guardian researcher and director of the Akala Ancient Tech Lab. Doctor... Robbie! Was that an electric guitar riff? In any case, I really am impressed that you made it all the way out to this rather remote location. Did you perchance meet Pura and borrow her power? Who's Pura? Yes, okay, that's fine if you don't know. Let's return to the subject at hand. Did you know that the Calamity is regaining its power? Yeah. I see, then you don't need to tell you my story. Yeah, tell me. I see. In that case... The goal of our Shiki research lab is simple, really. We aim to destroy the calamity that has endured across time, to rid Hyrule of its dark influence, and above all, to rescue Princess Zelda, who is now a prisoner of the calamity. Can I get dressed yet, man? We worked ourselves to the bone conducting our research. For a time, I feared I'd pass before we could prevail. However, you, Link, managed to awaken before this old sack of flesh gave out. That means the time is now. Yes. You! Now is the time to join forces with us, Shikia. Yes, we must destroy the Calamity. This guy's like rocking out, man. Let's do it. Personal space, dude. Could you back it up just like a foot? Can I have 1 foot? You and I are going to join forces to end the Calamity. On that note, sorry for the long preamble. I'd like to provide you with some ancient soldier gear. Yes, please. Did you catch all that? Give me the gear. Sherry, the ancient oven, she creates ancient soldier gear, but I feel she's all out of sorts at the moment. I don't know what he's doing. I'm afraid someone will have to bring the blue flame from the ancient furnace again. Ah, fuck me, man. The blue goddamn flame. I hate the blue flame. Morning. And check it out. Am I supposed to take your picture? I figured I'd give an impression of Hateno Ancient Tech Lab's director Pura a shot. Maybe it was just a bit much for a first time meeting you, though. Yes. Link, don't worry about it. It's all okay. So what do you need from me? Who are you? I should have put pants on before I went to talk to this lady. Check it out! I'm an amateur scholar of ancient history. To be honest, I've been focusing a lot on my research on shrines. That reminds me. Link, there's somewhere you need to go. The Left Eye of Skull Lake. There's a shrine there, but it's a challenge to get to it. The Left Eye of Skull Lake is higher up. The right one is lower down. If you run into Kilton, you are on the wrong eye. You have any other questions? What's the deal with Robbie? Is he single? It's not just that his eyes are doing that, but it's that he's standing here like this while it's happening. He was studying the gardens at Hyrule Castle 100 years ago. Robbie, we're half a century apart age-wise, but he'd never let that get in the way. He and I are married. Okay. I mean, I could. Let's see. Ancient Tech Lab. We have a son as well. If you have any other questions, who's your son? That's right, I've got one son. His name is Grant. I'm just gonna call him Grant, because I don't know what Grante is supposed to sound like. No, fuck, I'm calling him Grante. You seen him in your travels? No. Really? Well, if you see him, be nice to him, okay? Got any other questions? No. See you later. Just gonna chill with my neutery. I'll try to avert my eyes from your neutery. Man, this place is falling the fuck apart. Alright. Where the old scientist is married to the hot chick for no reason? Wasn't she a robot? I think you're referencing season one. I think that that young lady might have been a robot. Do I have anything that'll light on fire? Or do I have to grab that guy's torch? Let's get rid of the spear, because who wants even spears? Go inside and grab the torch. The reasons were ratings. I feel like I'm the kind of guy that knows what he means when he says that a woman is a robot. Gene Roddenberry was kind of sleazy. I mean, there's not any argument here. I have a hard time reconciling the sleaziness of the director or producer or whatever Roddenberry was against... Oh, shit. Against the progressiveness of the show in general, because it was an incredibly progressive show. But it was still fucking creepy as shit. How do I get there? How do I get there? Oh, you are on my fucking list, maze thing. Maybe I'll do you by accident, just like I did the last one. Alright. Can I get... Alright, I can go this way. Oh, I gotta fight that thing real quick. No, I'll keep my torch on. I don't give a fuck. Or, can I fight... Can I use the Master Sword on it? Yes, I can! Ah, I fucked up. I only fucked up a little bit, though. Whoop, shit. Yeah, there was a lot of weird shit that went down on that show, though, man. No, don't kill my horse! Just... kill me! Take me instead! I just saw Theory say something in Discord? I think he may be... We were talking about Twitch affiliates. But I think he may be referencing Twitch partners. I thought I saw him pop into the stream here, so I'm not sure if you're listening, Theory, but I think you're talking about the wrong monetization system. Fuck. Partners, yeah. The Twitch affiliates system is, like, it's almost Twitch Partner Lite. Kill all these things now. Right in the beak. What's the difference? You're still a monetized channel. You know what? I'm gonna lightning shock all these fucks. You are still a monetized channel, however, you... I don't think you get a sub button. You get one emote, and you can receive bits as a donation. I think in order to qualify for it, you have to have had 500 minutes of streaming in the last month. You have to have had 7 different days of streaming in the last month. And... fuck. And you need to have, I think... you have to have a much lower concurrency rating. Like, it's only... oh, I'm pushing the wrong fucking button for shielding, that's why. It's only like 3 concurrent viewers. I've seen a couple of people get it. Yeah, 3. I know Major got an invitation, and that is super awesome, because that kid is amazing. He's an excellent stream. Plays a lot of Hearthstone, and he plays it really well. Now, I'm not... the thing is I assume I have a concurrency of 3 viewers, but I don't know that that's true. And it's an average, so... and I've had streams where basically nobody showed up. It hasn't happened recently, but it has happened. I'm sure that affects the average, but as far as minutes streamed and unique days streamed, I know I have that in the bag. I also don't know. I do appreciate it, by the way. I also don't know if get him. I also don't know if everyone who meets those criteria got an invitation. Because it's entirely possible that they created a pool of all of those people and then sent invitations to 20% of them. And that's it, you know. Like, Moblin Club is better than my... I guess I'll get rid of that then. Where's this damn doodad? Oh, there it is. So I don't know if I can do this. Without, really? Okay. Yeah, I honestly, like, I'm not worried about it whether I do or not. The goal of this channel has never been monetization. Not that I would turn it down, but I've never sought it out. Like, there's a reason I don't have a donation button. Because I don't... That's not what the point of this was. The point of this was, I wanted to practice public speaking, first of all. I wanted to meet a bunch of cool people who were interested in the same games as me. I wanted to talk about... Like, I have a lot of... Before I started streaming, there were a lot of times when I would be at work, and I would have an idea about a game, and I would just ramble at my coworkers about what I thought was wrong with... the Darkwing Duck video game for NES that was essentially a okay but not great Mega Man clone. And I would go on and on about that game, and nobody gave a shit except for me. Streaming is an outlet for that, because now I get to just decide, I'm gonna play fucking Darkwing Duck. We're gonna play some Darkwing Duck. And then while I'm playing it, I'm like, what I really like about this is he can pull up his cloak, and that shields him from projectiles, and that's something that Mega Man didn't have. However, this game doesn't let you power slide, which Mega Man did do that, and Mega Man had more different items that you could use, but Darkwing Duck has this other thing happening. Like, I can make those comparisons, and the people who show up, presumably, are there by choice and can choose to hang out with me. You know? Like, I don't have to bother my fucking coworkers about it. And then on top of that, there was another video game related reason. Streaming changes the way... Yes, it's on fire. This is fucking great. Can I... Yes. That's what I was afraid of. I think I can... How fast can I run? Yes! Okay, this was the whole idea. This was the reason I brought my horse up here in the first place. I missed. How do I get down? Streaming changes the way that you interact with the game itself. Because I'm trying to be entertaining, I'm looking for things to talk about in the game. And because I'm actively looking around the game world, I'm more observant. I'm, like, looking for shit. You know, I tend to rush through it less. I experience the game in a different way. Come on. You can do it, horsey. You know what? I'm gonna skip a couple. Well, it is now raining. Which means it's a good thing I got that one. But now I have absolutely no way of proceeding in this quest until it stops raining. I wonder if there's a fireplace in the research lab, because if there is, I can skip forward until tomorrow, or whenever. I'm gonna leave my horse there, because then I'll know exactly where the fire is. Oh, yeah, absolutely. If you have any games that you'd like to see, I have a list. Actually, I probably have several years worth of streaming games. If I play Mario Brothers on Sundays and Zelda on Fridays, and whatever else I feel like on Wednesdays, I've got a lot of Wednesday content that I could do. But if there was something that you were interested in seeing, let me know, because I have a bunch of games. There are some things that I probably won't play. Like, I don't think I'm going to play Chrono Trigger. I can barely bring myself to play Final Fantasy VI anymore because, man, turn-based random encounter RPGs, I have a bad time streaming those. Like, they just, I don't think that they're entertaining. I spend a lot of time in a sullen silence as I'm walking from one town to the next and I keep getting attacked by plants. I don't fucking care. There is no fireplace here, and yet I can't teleport to here yet because the guy hasn't unlocked the thing because I need the blue fire. Does this always... Never Final Fantasy anything? Really? I mean, the games are good, it's just that I don't think that they make for... I have something to do. I have something to do, I have something to do, I have something to do, I have something to do. I think the games are good, I just don't think that they make for good streaming, because so much of the time is spent dealing with the random encounters that are the same, basically the same, every time. And you're like, okay, you use tools, you use blitz, you use regular attack, you use heal. Okay, we finished the encounter again, let's take another 8 steps on our way to Zozo, and then have it all happen again. Like, it really starts to get hard to be entertaining in that space. Walking out of the gate? What gate is that? What do you mean? And I mean, in fairness, some of the games are better than others. But by and large, they're all fine. Like, they're all... The first mob... Oh, like, you just didn't have a handle for the combat mechanics? I've had that happen to me. I don't fucking get it! How do you do it? Come on, gotta get there. I think I'm taking the fastest route. Think. I don't fucking know, man. Don't get me wrong, I love me some keyboard. I grew up with one of these in my hand. Like, I should have logged off about 5 minutes ago. I should have been getting ready for, come on, skip, go. Go fight, win. I should be getting ready for raid. But the Blood Moon came up. And there's a shrine that we can end on. I just gotta get there faster. Okay, I can stand on that edge. Probably. Let me stand. No, let me stand! Fuck! Even with all my power. Oh, it's not a blood moon anymore, though! How in the world am I supposed to get this? There must be a closer warp place to where I am. What is it like flying in from here? This sucks. You gotta stand naked on that one pillar when the blood moon happens and a shrine opens. I'm gonna find out what happens, and if I can't get there, Just climb and wait. You gotta be quick like a bunny to get this one, I bet, man. Oh, and it's raining now, so I can't even do it. Unless I can fly straight. Oh, son of a bitch. Okay, now I know. This is the way to do it. It's still the night of the blood moon, so maybe it'll still count, but I doubt it. Okay, next time the blood moon happens, I have to start at that shrine and fly in this way. I wish I had thought of that. Fuck. That stinks. Okay. It's okay, though. Next time on Breath of the Wild, we are going to finish running the blue fire up to the place. We're going to do something about some kind of, ancient armor or something the guy had. Maybe do a little bit more exploring in Akala, and then I want to hit up the other mountain. Hebra, I think, was what it was called. Do a little exploration there, because we haven't really done anything up there yet. Definitely going to have to bring my snow boots with me for that. And I have my cold weather clothing that I bought from the bird people. So that's set and good to go and happy and squared away. But that's going to be it for The Legend of Zelda. The pre-raid show is now over! The raiding show will now begin on World of Warcraft. Thanks everybody for hanging out. Real quick, if you saw this on YouTube, you could have seen it live at twitch.tv/Bartholomew_CTR. You can follow me right there at Bartholomew_CTR on Twitter for alerts for when I'm going to go live. The next show is going to be tomorrow. Old School Wednesdays, we're going to be playing a little bit more Kingdom Hearts. That is the game plan. 6 p.m. Eastern. See you there. Or see you someplace else, maybe. Or not. I don't know. Don't show up if you don't want. It's fine. See ya.